thousands have applied, but only 40 have been chosen.
Skeleton! Shut up!
Fresh! Fresh! Let's go!
Don't roll your fucking eyes up to heaven at me! Do you understand that?
That's it, is it? That's all you got?
No.
Well then, get up there!
Come on, go! Let's go!
Over 17 of the toughest weeks of their lives, these young recruits will have mind, body and spirit pushed to the limit, and one in three will fall along the way.
This isn't the fucking Boy Scouts. The next person I catch, go on, ouch, I have a thistle in me fucking hand. I'll kill you stone day.
Some aggression, drive him, come on, be a winner!
Willing to sacrifice anything. It's the end goal and watching.
There's a bus back there, you can go and get on it. You know, I'm leaving for it all day.
I have never been as disappointed in a body of troops. I'd say most of you would be lucky to be fucking kept in the army.
Just a matter of taking it on the chin, doing what you have to do and getting back up and going again.
Give the four goals!
Let's go!
Hardship forces a group of people together. It forms stronger bonds.
You have some of the best friends you'll ever develop when you're in there for 17 weeks, and they'll always be friends with one another. There's guys there now that, if push come to shove, would die for one another because of the bond they make.
40 people, 17 weeks, one goal. Who will make it all the way from civilian to soldier?
All right, Martin, you good?
40 new recruits arrive at the Curra Army Camp in County Kildare. For the next 17 weeks, they will undertake the basic military training they need to become soldiers.
Best of luck.
Jim Stockman.
An age spread between 17 and 24, people that are straight out of secondary school, you have people that have done degrees, you have other people that would have worked before, and some people, I suppose, that wouldn't have been lucky enough to have a job, maybe were unemployed before they came here.
I do remember my first day when I showed up. I remember the tea and coffee, remember the nerves, all these uniforms, all these rank markings. I had no idea what was going on, really. I just remember that there was a colonel stood up and told us that he would make soldiers of us.
You're all very welcome to the Defence Forces Training Centre. You're all very welcome to the 1st Armoured Cavalry Squadron. Your sons and daughters, partners, brothers, sisters are going to be trained in the 1st Armoured Cavalry Squadron for the next 4 months. The training will be tough. We make no apologies for that. It was a very competitive recruitment campaign. You're the top 40. There's another 40 and another 40 and another 40 waiting behind you. So you have to grab that opportunity and you have to make the best of it.
So just listen up there. When I tell you to stand to attention, just bring your 2 feet together and 2 hands in tight down by your sides, yeah? So stand to attention. Sit. And walk on.
I'm after actually playing 3 times. Third time lucky. Nerve-wracking at start, but it's good to get here now and just get stuck in.
From a young boy, he just wants to be in the army. He actually lives it, eats it, sleeps it. First time he wasn't accepted, he was devastated. And then he tried again, this was his last chance. So it was great, delighted for him.
Didn't fill out any CAO, what do you want to do in college? I don't want to do college. No interest in anything on the army. Siobhan, like, we're together now nearly 5 years, so got down on one knee, engaged now, wait till the training's over and see what happens.
No need to look at us or look around you. Pick a spot on the wall and that's what you look at.
I'm looking forward to see what they're going to throw at us. I don't know if that's a good thing or a bad thing. My twin sister's actually a private soldier in Kilkenny Barracks. So over the last few years, seeing her actually made me want to be a part of it.
They're naturally tough girls, right? They're small, they're tough.
Or hardy.
Yeah, they're hardy, yeah.
We should kind of put ourselves in that frame of mind. You know, once I'm up here now, I just go and get the head down. And, well, that's the advice the sister gave her anyway. Keep your head down and get on with it and say nothing.
I do solemnly swear that I will be faithful to Ireland and loyal to the Constitution. And
they swear an oath to stay loyal to the Constitution and to the state. Now they are recruits, they're no longer civilians, so they're now subject to military law.
Do you understand that as a member of the Permanent Defence Force, you must be prepared to obey orders which may involve the risk of injury or death?
I've applied before and I got it this time, luckily enough. Since the age is 25 for the cut-off, so I guess this was my... They finally took me in, I guess. Like, I couldn't see myself doing anything else than switch up.
It's possibly like any other young fella.
into the football and hurling. Got interested in the karate when he was 12, and he's a four-time black belt. I think Dan wouldn't stick an office job for 5 minutes. He wants to be out, he wants to be active. Went on to college, but I don't think he will ever settle down to 9 to 5. I think the army actually will suit him down to the ground. You know, I suppose time will tell.
Training is going to be tough. Be under no illusions, okay? This is not a picnic. It's not a fucking day camp. You're going to be tired. You're going to be pissed off. You're going to be miserable. It's preparing you so that when you go to Syria and you're shot at, you don't cave. I will not accept bad attitudes. I will not accept back answering or bullshit like that to NCOs or to myself. Ye all want to be here. Ye all fought hard to be here. But now you have to show me that you deserve to be here.
Hey. Less than 2 hours on the base, and recruit O'Boyle is drawing attention to himself.
Put your hands out of your pocket and your back answer me. Why? You don't know. Remember where you are now, right? You're in the army now, okay?
Careful.
Let's go. Careful.
It's inevitable that people are going to be a small bit nervous from the minute you land. You're told where to go, where to stand, what way to turn, where to look even. And I suppose that's a major culture shock for a lot of people.
Like, I hadn't come here in 4 months growing it out. Got stuck with this now. Go home, show my friends, laugh at me. Tried college, it wasn't for me. Came here, see if this actually is for me. I don't think I'll last now. I'm a bit of a mummy's boy. I'm used to just sitting at home with my mum, making me everything. And I have to do everything by myself.
Mad. A bundle of energy. Seriously, you'd put him down, gone. Up trees, crazy. Always had a football. Definitely a mummy's boy. Breakfast in bed, dinner up to the room. So I always thought that if Dara ever left home, he'd never be able to mind himself because he'd never done anything for himself. My friends call me the proud mammy. I'm constantly talking about him. There isn't one person in Selwich, I don't think, that doesn't know you're in the army. The house is so quiet without him. I'd be sobbing like a baby. Monday I'll be crying, Tuesday I'll be crying. I'll probably cry sort of for a couple of hours every day for the next week. When his dad died, he just left the three of us. So we became close, looking after each other. So, man of the house. If it was parents, easier, but when it's just yourself, it's, oh God, it's dreadful. But if it's what he wants to do, I'll support him, you know?
Discipline is the base on which you form your training. Everything about an army is discipline. If you let discipline slide, well, then everything else will slide with it.
Point start switching on. Just because you've had breakfast doesn't mean you switch off. Full bellies. You all going to lie down and rub your bellies.
No, corporal.
Switch on.
Every morning, the corporals inspect the recruits at parade. Each recruit is paired with a buddy, responsible for making sure each other's grooming and uniform are in perfect order.
Your pocket's open as well, Byrne. Take a step to the rear, get off parade. Take a step to the rear and get off parade. Do it properly. O'Boyle, did I ask you to bend down? Did I?
No,
take a step to the rear and get off parade.
If the recruit and their buddy haven't got everything in order, it means one thing, corrective action for both of them.
Arms out! Arms out! Sufin, arms out straight! How many times do you have to be told?
Everybody's told at the start, when you're getting in trouble, it's nothing personal. But it's just instilling the discipline in them. And you learn from your mistakes quick enough because nobody wants to get bottling. Nobody likes a bottling. Do you know, it's embarrassing and just you don't want to be shouted at. You know, you just want to do it right. So they learn quick enough.
At the core of basic training is physical exercise. None of the recruits is army fit. That will change.
He didn't ask you to talk, did he? No one asked you to talk when you fall in. You fall the fuck in and stay quiet. That's the way it's done, yeah?
Yes, Corporal.
That's a sergeant. That's a sergeant.
Yeah?
Three.
We must work together.
Four.
We must work together.
Do your job.
One.
Come on, get up there. Do your job.
I was made a runner for my last job on the lookout for something different. I was a care assistant, so that's a bit of a change, all right.
Dig into yourself. Honest effort everywhere.
There's only myself and another girl. We're teaming up well.
You have to get on because there's only the two of you, and at the end of the day, like, we're going to be best friends, but we just have to have each other's back no matter what.
It was hard, it was tough. When you're getting that shower, you can feel proud of yourself. You've done a good job for your first PT session, everyone.
After 14 hours of grueling physical exercise, military training and lectures, the recruits must spend their evening getting ready for the following morning's inspection. Everything must be squared away.
It's tough, like, I was so free when I was at home. And now I keep my clothes clean and dusting three or four times a day and going to sleep at 11:30 where I'd normally be up till the morning. I made the bed for the first time in about 2 years yesterday.
Phone's gone at 10:50, yeah, so it's time to give them up, get them ready to go.
So you can turn off Queen and Richie Kavanagh,
whatever you're listening to there.
Rod Stewart,
cop. Rod Stewart.
One of the major changes when they were told that they would only have their mobile phones for 2.5 hours a day, there were some people anxiety issues about being separated.
It kind of reminds me of being back at school, like you're kind of being told what to do and when to do it and how to do it. Like.
I was never a morning person, you know. I never had a clock would have been early for me, but like, you used to go to bed at about 2:30, 3 o'clock every night, you'd be home. If you watch the Rambo, you watch Anna Tall on the telly. They're up there about 7:15 if there's 2 or 3 corporals coming every morning inspecting the room.
Oh, Jesus. Oh, yeah.
Are you
right.
Shitting me?
Sorry,
Corporal,
it's not
your main height. Go laugh! It's not going
to
be funny.
Like, it's a bit of a shock to the system to begin with. You're going from meeting everyone and all of a sudden you'll be put in your place every second of the day. Like, I wouldn't be too affected by it. Like, my father is an ex-Garda sergeant. Like, I know what it's like to be shouted at, let's say.
Let's go! Bit of aggression now! Come on! Some aggression! Drive him! Come on! Drive him! That's it! Come on! Drive! Come on! Come on, Johnny! Push him!
Loser!
On me! Three! Four! Five! Back in! Johnny, come push on! Him.
Physically, it's picked up a lot. Like, yesterday's PT session, it was heavy, heavy going. If I hadn't done that on the first day, now it would have been wheeled out in a wheelchair. So I would.
Let's go!
Recruit training is a mental challenge. People are purposely put under pressure to see, do they break, basically.
Bend your fucking arms, though!
If they're going to be serving overseas in the likes of Syria or the Golan Heights in a year or a year and a half's time, we need to have soldiers that don't cave under pressure and that don't crack.
What's wrong? Why are you? You don't want to do this.
I am stopping you inside for myself.
What's wrong with you? You're not able for it. There's a bus back there. You can go get on it. You're not able for it all day. All day we're at you.
Stand to attention when the corporal's talking to you.
Oh, Jesus. Do you hear this?
O'Neill, on me now.
Oh, Jesus.
Come on me.
Not able for it.
You get them as young recruits, and then you turn them into the soldier that you want them to be. There's an old saying in the army, to make them, you have to break them.
Come on! Burn down runners off!
Attrition has set in. Even at this early stage, some recruits are struggling.
In the first week, there's 2 people have chosen to leave. The second person left today, recruit Sheehan, didn't want to drag it out anymore. It's a bit of a nightmare, the first 3 weeks, because you're constantly bringing in new people.
I was working in security, yeah. You know, I wanted to sort myself out. Little lad, 2 November. It's for him and it's for my girlfriend as well. As well for myself as well, like, you know, to make something of myself.
And then on the other side, you're discharging the other people.
Yeah,
I'm not.
Any particular reason? I just don't have the mentality.
Just not what you
thought it
would be?
I said I'd try it out. Just to see if I could hardware myself into becoming a soldier, but I just don't think I have what it takes.
Okay. We're going up to the military police centre to pick up the latest recruit to come in. He's going to come in here, not going to know what's going on, he's not going to know anybody, so I'd say he's pretty nervous, all right.
With almost a week gone, 19-year-old Mark Duffy joins the troop. The training can't slow down for any individual. It'll be up to him to catch up as quickly as possible.
Last night, I forgot about 3 hours sleep because I was just too nervous to come up to date. I've been involved in civil defence for a few years, and I've been in the scout centre for a good few years than that as well. I've been a scout since I'm about 6 years of age.
So your first name, as on your birth cert, is Mark?
Yeah.
Grant. And your surname is Duffy on your birth cert? Yeah. Grant.
Shoulders straight, in the ground. Don't bend your finger. You're not in the Boy Scouts. Okay. Turn your hand slightly. So it's the longest way up, and then the shortest way down. Sheath.
A new guy coming in, you're all welcoming him to him and try to get him up to air speed because you don't want to see him getting in trouble because he is like one of us. You really do feel like a bond going on.
He'll get on grand. We'll welcome him. We'll take him under our wing in section threes.
A good few people were like, yeah, that's great following your dreams and all that. But then other people are just, are you insane really going to the army? But like, these are the people I'm going to be friends with like for the rest of my life.
Even at this early stage, recruits know that their growing sense of camaraderie is vital to military life. The bonding is genuine. It'll help them get through the tough weeks ahead.
Second day I was here and I was pretty homesick because we didn't know each other. It's like already we're all good friends at night time now, so a bit of crack.
Straight line, straight
line.
You already have nicknames. Though I was about 6'7", so he's called Tiny.
I was doing a strong man, and at one stage I was 25 stone and 18 stone now, and still the running catches me a little bit.
Recruit O'Dowd is a big man. Because of his sheer size, I think a lot of them look up to him. Literally, like, they look up to him.
Absolute gentleman, big friendly giant, does everything for us. My bed broke the other night, believe it or not. I sat down and the hinges were gone off it. And it's about 15 stone to carry, so I couldn't carry it. It says, that work from here. Oh, yeah. Anyway, a great time for all that, but he sounds about now.
Recruit MacDonald likes to walk his lurchers and go for a bit of hunting and that in the field, so yeah, he's quite a funny character.
Because he has two lurcher dogs, I don't know what he's talking about now, but like, we just nicknamed him Lurcher.
That's your idea, son.
Yeah, Sergeant, I fell off last night. And...
you know what? I give you top marks for effort, Mac. Because it's a good effort. Fair play to you, right?
You know, I never like needles. You know, even going through school, getting all the injections, I hate them. Oh, pain in the arse, man. I got the first one this morning. She put it in and took it out and all water, and I looked at her. That was the worst thing I'd done. As a boy, it just came at me and went a bit dizzy.
He just felt a little bit weak.
You're on yourself.
Like, some lads are in pieces with MacDonald. He nearly passed out, like.
The best medicine, a cup of tea and a few slices of toast, you know.
We'd be a quiet lad during the day. Once the lights turn out and we're in bed, just can't shut him up.
Oh, he's a good storyteller. He has plenty of life experience by the sounds of him.
Oh, yeah, the chats go down, for sure. They have to be kept behind closed doors and on yourself now. We say no more.
Just looking forward then to next week, straight away from Monday morning, boot sticking in. It's time to up our game, all right? It's time to let them know that we expect more from them, all right? Definitely be one or two, I'd say, dropping on Monday after the weekend and that. And once they see that it's not all fucking holding hands and everything like it was the first 2 weeks. Sir.
Okay, so Paul, we'll just have a quick review of where we are. So we start with section one.
Good people in section one so far are people that are standing out with Connery.
Okay.
He's doing well.
One, two, three, and four! The base and nine!
You have very strong characters in section three. Undoubtedly, he's performing very well. Okay. And is keeping the section very much in check. You have people in it that at the minute are kind of popping up in lights.
Performance or attitude? Or combination?
Oh boy, his attitude towards NCOs not taking too well to what he's being told. And at this early stage, it shouldn't really be as much in light with me to put
okay.
I know them better than I should at this stage.
How many times do you have to be told to do something? Why didn't you do it? Why didn't you do it?
It's a bit of a golf show now, the first 2 weeks, for head down and going along now and try. Try hard.
Sometimes when I'm talking to him on the phone, I can hear it in his voice that it's a bad day, it was tough today, do you know, that kind of a thing. And he's sucking it up. As you know, anything great isn't easy, so, but you're doing it.
From when they first arrived in 2 weeks ago to now, you can see a change. It's probably too early to tell if they'll be good soldiers or not.
It's the end of their second week, and the recruits are looking forward to their first weekend pass home, with spirits high and only hours to go before they leave. Keeping their focus is essential.
Up until Friday, they had got on relatively well this week, and even when they were on the hill walk, I was quite happy with their progress. Today could have ended on a high for them going home.
There was a bit of an incident coming back on the bus. One of the recruits decided to back answer one of the NCOs. Sure, we have to deal with it accordingly.
I don't know how you can forget things that have been drilled into you for the last 2 weeks. When you do a handy little walk up the hills, you come back here and you fall apart. You shouldn't fucking be here if that's how bad you are, if you can't remember stuff that's been drilled into you for 2 weeks.
One of the recruits just wasn't doing what he was taught at all. I asked him then what was wrong with him, and he told me that he had forgotten everything that he had learned in the last 2 weeks.
Do you have a problem with taking orders from a female?
No, sergeant.
You better fucking not have. Because that lady's a fucking NCO. She's earned the stripes that she wears, and she's earned them fucking well. And if you disrespect that woman again, O'Boyle, you won't last here. Is that understood?
Yes, sergeant.
You better fucking not upset any other NCOs here when you come back Sunday night. You're on a very fucking thin step, as we're talking about. Never again is another recruit going to back answer an NCO. Well, you're in my troop anyway. That's a fact. I can guarantee that from here on in.
1, 2, 3, 4. I love the Cavs Corps.
Let's count it as one. We do 10 of them. Right, so. 2. Let's have it.
1, 2, 3, 4. I love the Cavs Corps.
Yes, you fucking do.
Shut up all the fucking moaning. Just do it.
1, 2, 3, 4. I love the Cavs Corps.
Get ready. And down.
1, 2, 3, 4. I love the Cavs Corps.
Get up. I'm doing it properly. You can't put your belt down properly. You can't do a press-up. You shouldn't be here.
I'm getting frustrated with myself. Letting down everyone else. You know what I mean? Letting down the section that you're in, the troops, because they get in trouble for that as well.
Go right down. Have a look at his face. Look at him. He's hurting because you wanted to back answer an NCO. Now look to your right and look at his face.
1, 2, 3. Now, just bend them elbows. Back up.
Fucking disgrace. The fucking hugging and the holding the hand shit all stops Monday morning. So those of you that have any fucking doubts whether you should be here or not, go home, sit in front of the mirror, drink your cup of tea, get mammy to rub your feet, brush your hair, rub your shoulders, whatever the fuck you want them to do, and have a good, solid, hard look at yourself and decide whether you want to be here or not.
Some of you are going to meet a big change come Monday morning. Some of you there can't even put a belt on your trousers.
Nice bonding day for you, isn't it? Fucking it all up.
You want to fucking switch on, troops?
I'll tell you one thing. Enjoy this weekend.
Can't hack it. You shouldn't be here. Do you hear that as well, Barbara?
Yes,
sort out your dress as well for parade Monday morning. Do you understand me?
Yes, Father.
You look like a fucking bag of shite standing there.
All the sections need better come back on Monday with a different attitude. Do you hear me?
Yes, Father.
We don't want time wasters. We'd rather bring someone else in here that'll give 100% effort. Someone that deserves to be here. Yous all understand that?
Yes, Father.
To be honest, I don't know what it's going to be like, that's the truth. It's just going to get mayhem, and it's really who's going to stay through it. But we look forward to getting home the weekend now and chillax and all. Can't wait to see the old lurchers, of course. Just sit after the knife again, just not getting up a half six and being roared every morning, you know yourself, like, pain, the whole, what can you do?
The honeymoon phase is over. The hand-holding is finished. I think there's some of them possibly wavering, and I think week 3 is going to be either the kick into gear or to kick out the door for some of them.
The recruits have returned to the Curragh for the beginning of their third week of training. For many, the first fortnight adjusting to life in the Defence Forces has been difficult. And some have misgivings.
as I was coming in, I felt sick, just because Friday was so hard and I was expecting it then Monday as well. And some of the boys, like I even said to someone, they're like, oh yeah, we're the exact same.
Mammy will pamper them, tell them they're great lads, and then after 2 days at home, oh no, do I want to go back to the big bad man back here in the Curragh? The tempo and the intensity are going to change dramatically. You'll really get to see who the strong characters are in the troop, and the guys that are falling behind then will need to decide what they want to do with themselves.
Whoever happens next, it can only get better. Remember that.
Why isn't your lockers open?
Open your lockers.
Open your lockers now.
Are you okay, son? Open it up. Why aren't the lockers open? Why aren't the lockers open? It's the open, come on.
Hurry up, hurry up.
Why isn't it hanging up your
lockers? Fucking shite that is.
Anybody on your
uniforms? Do you want your mother to do it for you? Will I ring and get the minute to do it for you?
No, not only they're not buttoned up. He has his boxes over to the right. Why are yours over to the left?
Uniformity, yeah?
Them.
No,
it's
really
still
staying
shite on it.
Dirt,
you
run it.
You're told this last.
I don't give a shit, no number. No number? Number on that? No.
So what's
the main
button
number on it?
So William's show that in the middle of the hall now, everyone else is telling me you wouldn't know which number's yours.
What are you telling me that is for? Are you told about a number on it? You were? Yes, why? Yeah. Is it yours?
Yeah, so
yeah.
Identify a
carpet. Yeah, now how are we going to identify it?
That water's in there since we went on the walk Friday.
Don't fucking lie to me. What's going to happen if you leave water like that and you drink it?
You get the shits, that's what's going to happen.
You're going to get sick. What good are you then to the rest of the fucking section? What good are you? You're no good. Because they'll end up carrying you everywhere then. Why? Because you're fucking lazy.
I can see it from here.
Something hanging out of your right nostril.
I don't want to be seeing shit like that hanging out your nose tomorrow.
Mine's on top on the floor because you get stuck in it the side of it.
Oh, you learn. This week you learn.
Two!
1, 2, 3, 4, I love the Cavs
core! Louder!
1, 2, 3, 4, I love the Cavs core!
Get off your knees, McDonald's!
The training gets harder for everybody. Expectations grow with the weight in the recruits' backpacks. Every day, additional equipment is added to their kit.
Every morning is getting harder. We had run yesterday now and every part of my body is sore.
Let's go! Let's go! Come on!
I mean, sometimes you'll be under fierce pressure, like, you know. It's not stopping you from going home. If you want to go home tomorrow morning, you'll just say, look, corporal sergeant, they want to go home. Say, me discharge papers.
Dalton, you gonna fucking puke your ring out here, are you? Destroy this beautiful grassland. You better fucking not, you can swallow it and bring it with you.
The NCO's job to try and get the best out of each individual and that they are being pushed towards breaking point. That's why the NCO's don't want to see someone give up.
Oh, you're walking, walk. Get up! Get up! What you left the mind down for?
That person has more to give. They just don't realise it themselves, mate.
The 17 weeks is the tool that we use to build someone's character.
A fucking half-arsed effort. The pair of ye, get the fuck up there with the rest of them. Stop walking. Come on!
You do get to a point when you're on the PT run, that's it, I've had enough, you want to collapse. And several times when you'd be literally there, I'm borderline, I'm just going over to that bush and throwing up into it. You just have to blank out every single thing that's going through your mind, get on with it, and just think to yourself, right, there is an end to this.
Don't be trying to lean forward. Just stand up. Just stand up straight.
Get it off.
Just stand up straight.
Get it off.
Right, go on, go on, have it.
Lay down.
Yeah.
Sit down.
Come on, just keep drinking your water and listen to Corporal Dodds. He knows what he's doing, he's trying to do it, so just do what he says.
I know you want to do it, right? I know you do. Right now, we have to take your health and your family, right? Get some water on. What we're going to do is going to bring you in. You have to get your look on, okay? Barbara. Stop. You'll finish it tomorrow. It's always tomorrow. Keep breathing. Keep it breathing. Stop. Relax. Good man. Good man. You're doing well. No, stop. Stop. You're only new into the troop. Keep your head up. Keep the breathing. You're only new into the troop. All right? They have 2 weeks extra training, you physically training on you, right? You will catch up. Go get yourself checked out now. Make sure everything's okay. All right?
Head up, dude. Head up.
Keep
Come
head
on.
Up.
Keep
your hands off your knees. Head up.
Keep your head up.
Nice and slowly, right?
I know you're going to get air into your lungs, man. Keep your head up.
Your hands wrap around Sergeant Bull. Okay?
Troop Barber has to go to Nace Hospital via ambulance. He's complaining of chest pains.
all this tomorrow.
We did what we could do. We put him on a bus and we brought him in. Listen to me now, listen to me, Barbara. And I'll send you with him. All right.
Out pissing up all weekend. Drinking all weekend. Eating shy.
You're only here a couple of days and this is the best you're going to give me. It's a fucking sad start to your life in the Defence Forces, isn't it?
What in the name of Christ was the problem out on the plains today? A simple little run and you can't all stay together in one group. Fella gone to the hospital. Lads can't keep up. Oh, I've a twinge in this, I've a twinge in that. The pistols are hurting me hand. Troops, this isn't the fucking Boy Scouts. Is that understood everywhere?
Yes, sir.
The next time or the next person I catch going, ouch, I have a tistle in me fucking hand, I'll kill you stone dead. That's bollocks, lads. Absolute, pure, utter shite is what that is. We put you under a little bit of pressure and this what happens? You fall apart at the fucking seams.
Any pride in yourselves? Share a little bit of pride.
We knew it was coming. We were told week 3 was going to be the fun week. Like, no, honestly, it was tough. Like, anyone who tells you otherwise is lying because they're all outside now with their aches and pains. Like, you can see people cracking. Like, so maybe one or two more. But if we can help it, we won't let them go. Like, so we'll talk them out of it.
Characters emerge in every troop. MacDonald is seen as one of the personalities who helps lift morale, but training has left him disheartened. Now it's his turn to see Lieutenant Ralph.
This is a chat, basically, to let you know how you're getting on. How do you think you're progressing today? How do you think your training has gone so far?
First 2 or 3 days, very, very homesick.
Okay.
Missing family and that.
Yeah.
Really, really going to hotel for the next 2 weeks.
Yeah.
Got home then the weekend and came back and was meeting there Sunday morning.
Fucked up.
Oh, like, unbelievable.
Okay. So,
I couldn't take it anymore. I packed a bag and I said to the sergeant that I'm going home. So he had a chat with me and the hell with it, I give it another go. Like, there's no point walking on this. Like, it's took so long to get into it, you know what I mean? Like, 20,000 people pay for this, and us 40 got it. Like, there was another female recruiter, Byrne. She was doing the same. She was, but she wanted to go home, you know?
It's been a shock to the system, all right. I suppose it's even more disciplined than I expected.
Okay, sit down. Okay. You're thinking of leaving here?
I know, yeah.
You're calling, so you're fully sure. Looking from our point of view, okay? Yourself and McDonald's. You're shaping up fairly good. I reckon there's good soldiers in you, all right? And that's why I would genuinely not like to see it really.
I can't. It's so much pressure, I don't know.
If you give it another week, I think you'll change your mind. I think if you leave today, you'll regret. Genuinely, I think you'll regret.
I regret, like, not being able to say that, but I did it, I don't know.
For
the pride.
Exactly, pride, your own pride. You're one of the fittest females I've ever seen fucking join the army, I'd say. Yourself and Kyo are impressing shit out of your fitness, all right? By staying here and giving me another week, you're going to do things that may have the potential to massively impact your life in the future. If you think in your mind, if you have any sense of a possible regret, I think you shouldn't leave. I don't want to see you go. And the same with McDonald's. What's your gut feeling now? Tough, isn't it?
Yeah. I think
one week. It's not a lot to ask. Give him another week for me.
Thanks. Like, I'm not, like, I have to, my heart doesn't do it, I don't know.
Okay. Go on over.
Release the actions. Okay, pick up a safe point, take a point of aim, squeeze the trigger. I place back on the safety catch.
8 members of the troop have left. Losing a person hits the section hard now that there are strong ties. And Kyo feels the loss of O'Byrne the most.
Yesterday was a hard day, in fairness. We've literally been living out of each other's pockets for the last nearly 3 weeks. But, like, the lads are great. Like, they weren't leaving me isolated up in the room by myself. Like, it just made you feel like you're actually part of it now and we're actually coming together like a family.
So, Paul, tell me, we're at 39 at the moment, is it?
Yes, sir. Yeah, we've, and as well as that, we have one in hospital as well.
We're at Barbara, yeah. What's Barbara's the situation there?
He's still in there. He was taken in Wednesday morning. It looks like he's a full body infection, a viral infection.
Anybody come to your attention for negative attitude or behaviour?
Negative reasons. There's one recruit particularly struggling. Duffy is struggling across the board. he's drawn an awful lot of heat on himself.
Duffy's recruitment call came a week into training. It's the fulfillment of an ambition for the young man from Waterford.
When they advertised, it was an opportunity. It was something that you really said you'd give it a shot, because Mark has always been into the outdoor pursuits, adventure sports, and he had an interest in the military, I suppose, structure and the lifestyle that they have.
I've always been heavily involved with scouts, and that's always something I'd always be big into, like from going straight from secondary school straight into the army like that. It was a huge jump. Like, I could be at college right now with the rest of my friends from school. I could be like going a night out and all that, but at the end of the day you're kind of like, I think I was right to make that choice. And the more you think about it, the more you realise, wait, this is what I want. You have to make sacrifices. So if you want something that you've always wanted, that's it, you have to sacrifice it. Always my dream, kind of when I get out of the base training, hopefully is to go into the snipers. You're just sitting there in the field, like, and you just got that patience, and it's just something so elite that there's something like that I just love to go for.
Don't let the man down beside you. Don't be the weak link. Who's the fucking weak link? Don't be him.
Okay, let's go. Let's pick it up.
Shoulder to shoulder the whole way. Come on. The CO is here. Let's show him what we're made of. One final drive everywhere. Come on. Dig in.
First week or two, difficult to say the least, as I'm going on, I'm slowly making mistakes. And my problem is that I'm learning all the mistakes, but I'm learning the hard way.
Recruits are given a list of equipment to bring with them. It's to get them used to carrying the weight. One of the NCOs noticed that Recruit Duffy's bag looked smaller than everyone else's.
This is all your weight here. Top and bottoms.
Yes, sir. That sort of weight here, isn't it? Huh?
You missed my pants.
Why haven't you got all the gear required in your desk?
I'll tell you why. Because you're cutting corners. You've been cutting corners since day one, since you got here. That's what that is. That's cutting corners. That's acting the bollocks. And every one of them there are flat out running around the place with all the gear in them. You're struggling and you don't even have all the kit in the fucking bag you were told to have. That's a fucking half-arsed effort. Is this what you're going to be for the rest of your recruit training? Cutting corners all over the place?
No, Sergeant. What's the training for corners, Sergeant?
Well, that's what it fucking looks like to me.
Duffy, they're bursting there. Fucking rear ends running around the camp outside. With all the gear that's supposed to have. And you come in with half of it. Half of it. How do you think that feels now to the rest of them? Not good. Put that gear into it. I don't even want to fucking. Put the gear back in.
Duffy, we're not finished. This is going to continue. You're going to have some serious explaining to do. Hurry the fuck up and pack that bag. Duffy, get in! Come on, everyone's waiting on you, Duffy. Get in!
He's made suffering because of you.
Wasn't there. I was almost 100% certain I packed everything away, but just that one slip, you don't double check something, that's it. You're done for. When you get caught for a mistake that you didn't even know you made, that makes it all the more difficult.
Take one pace forward.
Hurry up, Duffy. This is your warning. It's the only way I can put it, okay?
You've drawn a lot of heat in yourself.
Yes, sir.
The fact that every NCO knows your name, and I know your name, isn't good. I think you've had a rough start, right? I think your attitude is a good chunk of the problem.
Yes, sir.
There are a number of things. You don't have to keep saying yes, sir. I don't need you to reassure me that you're listening, because you better be listening. Because at this moment in time, I am very worried about where you stand, okay? I haven't decided yet what I'm going to do, okay? But at the minute, you are a concern for me. And if you're back in front of me again, you're in for fucking trouble.
Take a pace back. Clint P. Mark Rashad.
For 3 weeks, O'Boyle has drawn the attention of his superiors. He's in trouble, and he knows it.
The first few weeks, like, it was really hard. Couldn't grasp it. Just couldn't get it. For the first 2 weeks, I was getting bulletins the whole time. It was like, what is wrong with you? Why can't you get this? It's a game. Just switch on and switch off. I came back after on week 3 then, and I was just like, right, I'm just going to try to be a soldier.
From my point of view, okay, right, your first 2 weeks were a bit of a fucking disaster. Let's be honest, all right? Yeah. You went home on that Friday, fucked up, yeah? You got a chewing, and you came back with a different attitude. And that's good to see.
Egg up and play! Hey!
test today was to see that they've picked up the basics of marching and that they can follow commands. Myself and the lieutenant critiqued them and informed them whether they've passed or failed.
If I was to look at you on day one and look at you now, I'd say you're nearly a different person. And it's been noted on a massive scale how much your attitude has changed, okay? And that's good. You need to basically not slip back now to the way you were. You need to keep where you're going. You're going in the right direction. You have potential. Don't slip up, all right?
Gosse, Cortez!
Looking back at myself, Gosse. A little bit too laid back. Jeez. In every aspect of my life. I like how I'm changing. Like, I like what the military is doing to me. Hopefully I don't turn into a robot now after 17 weeks.
Well, you were always respectful, but more so now. You know, ma'am, please, and thank you. Okay. Where's my son gone? Yeah, there's a huge difference in you. He seems stronger.
Section 3, everyone passed. And O'Boyle was probably one of the best marching today, so he deserves recognition for that.
Pass it on. But you were probably the best. Right?
Yeah.
See, you put the effort in, how does it feel?
We don't know why.
Well, the corporal was even saying that I improved, so I was happy enough with that. This is me now, new man.
He's really turned it around. He's taken on board what he's been told. If he keeps going the way he's going, I have no doubt that he will make a good soldier.
Get a good point of aim, yeah? Can you see it? Okay, hold through, don't snatch, pull nice and through. Okay, relax, okay, breathe, pull through and hold. Okay.
When he came home the first weekend, he was saying, "It's really tough, ma'am." And I said, "Well, it's what you signed up for, do you know?" And he said, "Oh no," he said, "I'm not giving it up." No way was he giving it up. I knew I'd lost him. He's an army man now.
There.
That's very good. Right. Yeah. One of the best ones I've seen so far.
Is it?
You've gone 2-3 and you have a double here, right?
Good
very good.
Okay.
Good shooter. Right. Not much more to say there, okay? It's very good. Excellent. Excellent, sir. Good man. Good stuff, all right.
5 weeks in, the recruits prepare for inspection by higher ranks. This morning, it's the turn of Troop Sergeant Mullins. By now, the turnout should be perfect.
There's no halfway about anything. It's either fully closed or it's open. That's open to me. Pass the rear off parade. That's dirt then. It splashes off something when it's getting onto your smock. So, pass to the rear resident, sign the rest of them over there. You checked him before he went on parade?
Not right before, this morning I checked him.
Look.
Oh my
look.
God.
No, by right, I should swing out of that. Off the fucking parade. That's disgraceful. The fuck are all them? More trades. Join the fucking, the muckbirds over there.
There was very little sleep last night, so I'm expecting tomorrow night to be the same. They pull you on everything, like, you have to be 100%.
You started off very strong, okay? This week now, you've started to slip a small bit, okay? And I'm sure you know it yourself, because you just said there that you're starting to make small mistakes, all right? Exactly. So your standards are dropping slightly, okay? That's not something we want to see at this early stage of trends. You need to address them, okay? And you need to act fairly quickly.
Smallest of area, letting you down. You're told to clean the boot, you clean the fucking boot, right? Not only is there dirt in there, look at the rim of the boot. Another one again, look, I'm flicking it over. There's that much dirt in the fucking thing. The inspection today didn't go as well as one would have hoped. In a way, it's all destroying for the NCOs because they're putting time and effort and then it seems like that they're not taking any information on board. It's a fucking pitiful effort. Look at the dirt of the fucking glove that I'm walking out with. And I started with a white glove. It's a fucking disgraceful show of fucking effort is what it is.
If you can't do the small things, how the fuck can we trust you or get you to do the bigger things? The harder things that you're going to have to do in your life in this job. So at this stage, I'm sure when I start talking to you, you know what I want you to do, don't you?
1, 2, 3, 4, I love the cab corps.
1, keep it going.
1, 2, 3, 4.
There has been times when you're just like, fuck this and I'm sick of this now, bro. You know what I mean? You love to say to yourself, Jez, no one you can do it yourself. Why am I here? Like, why am I at home? There's 100 things you could be doing. Like, every morning I hate waking up and just having to do the same thing every day, listen to the same things, like...
Stand to attention when I'm talking to you!
You've some fucking attitude on you this morning.
Yet again, I'm trying to give you a bit of advice and you're throwing it back in my face. It's the last time I try and give you a bit of advice.
Oh, sure, I don't care.
That's it now. All the NCOs are fed up with you. We thought we could do something good with you. We thought we could train you up to be soldiers. But right now, I don't think any of you are up to any standard.
We had a bad day today now. We're all over the shop, so the whole troop is just in bits, really.
Ultimately, when they leave here, myself, Lieutenant Ralph, and the CO of the 1st Armoured sign their name to these guys. You do want them to portray what we've taught them, and that when they go to their new unit, that they can see, well, all right, them guys came from the Curragh, they've been trained to a good standard, they are a good soldier.
Duffy, you're platoon order, right? You're the last one out of the building. You're the one that goes to make sure it's secured. Do you understand?
Yes, Buck.
Water. Have you got water? Where is it? So you forgot water as well, eh? What the fuck is going on, Duffy? I don't think this is for you. You need to switch on. How are you going to be able to manage to hold a rifle? How are you going to be able to manage to lead men into missions?
We're not here to catch anyone out. I'm here to make soldiers. Anybody can change around. Anybody can go from struggling to being very good. So it's just a matter of putting in the effort, knowing that you want to be here.
He will stick through it. He wouldn't be a quitter. Anything Mark has ever done, he's always stuck by it, and he won't be the one to say, you know, that's
no,
it, I haven't.
He's sticking out to the bitter end. Yeah. He would always do that, yeah.
He'd text late at night and he'd have had a bad day. It can be difficult listening to him getting upset on the phone and trying to get through it.
Every night, if I get a chance to ring him up, I just straight away on the phone to him. Get off, yeah.
It's not all negative, okay? Something positive, your PT, all right, your fitness level is good, okay? The likes of marching you picked up quickly enough and the weapon you picked up quickly enough, all right? You're aware of the things that you're fucking up on. And it's not just you. In fairness, there's a good few members of the troop getting hit with stupid mistakes still that you shouldn't be at this stage, right? I want reports coming back to me on a daily basis that Duffy is changing his fucking attitude, okay?
Right. Thank you, sir.
I've always been told I'm quite resilient. I said to myself, I'm going to see my training all the way through to the end, no matter what. There's been so many people that haven't gotten the job, and you've been here, you've gone through it all, and you can say to everyone else at home, saying, I've done it. Like, it was one of the toughest things you've ever done in your life. You can say, I've done it.
Come on, make a good effort.
Of course I hope he steps up, but I'm not here to be unfair to anyone. And in fairness, since he was spoken to, he has put in a massive effort on PT. Was noted. So that's a good start.
Let's go! Let's go! Let's go! The whole way to the top! To the top! To the top! To the top!
Get up! Or go home, one or the other. Pass them out! They don't want to be the 104, they can go!
It's the end of McDonald's fifth week at the Curragh. After considerable soul searching, he asks to see Lieutenant Ralph.
Yeah, come in, sit down there, sir. Close over the door. Okay. Have a seat. You decided to leave, did you? You've had enough. Okay. Look, you gave it a fair shot. You gave it another week, which is all we could have asked, really, all right? You're held everything out there, are you? Why, you watched what? Just not for you?
My host, Marvin, said to myself, I've had feeling in a week.
Yeah.
He said, well, this can't carry on.
Okay. Look, no problem at all.
It was one change of a real person.
Yeah.
And you didn't like work. I just didn't agree with one of them. I just said, no, it's not going to be that. It was today or it was never. And I said to myself, it's going to have to be today. I want to say to myself, no, it mightn't be tonight, it mightn't be tomorrow, it could be a week, it could be a month. I could say to myself, I'm after making a huge mistake, but the way I'm looking at it now is I'm happy to go. That's the way it is now, you know. Something else out there, you know. It wasn't for me. I can't tell you know what I'm going to do because I don't know. I think it's just time to go back now and start back from the drawing board and see where it takes me. I don't know, like, some of them guys will probably never see again, you know, that's heartbreaking.
If McDonald's lost the spirit of their own, like, it's a bit different there now without me missing.
I could write to a list the length out of the water tower of the crack we had here. That used to get us through the day, you know, listening to telling stories and just having a bit of crack, like. The best way to blow off steam is just laughter and even him. I will miss being here. No pain in saying I won't.
Saying goodnight now in the room last night is like goodnight, Mac, and hearing nothing back. It's kind of
You feel it, like.
It was even a major blow for us because we wanted him to finish it out and stay because he was such a good character. They've bonded over the last 5 weeks, so it's going to be very hard for them just to readjust to it.
We were all a bit down the last couple of days over it. Like, you'd be shocked how much of a bond you'd make over such a short period of time. It's unbelievable. Like,
it does affect morale. If you have a real strong guy and he says, I've had enough of this, but then they automatically feel, oh no, if he's gone and he can't hack it, what are the rest of us going to do?
Go, 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 go. Keep going! Keep the fucking rifles out!
When one person leaves, get this ripple effect, he's out of this mess. That could be me as well, and I don't really have to put up with this any longer.
It's fucking atrocious. It's deplorable.
Your gear will be taken off you and given to your section if you can't keep up.
Shut up!
If that's not enough an incentive, what the fuck is?
If you're not a functioning member of a troop, you don't have a place within the Defence Forces.
Okay, squeeze my hand, squeeze. Squeeze, into the nose, out the nose. You with me again?
This week, struggling, but hopefully I'm getting used to it now and I'll kind of catch up with the rest of the lads.
Let's keep it going!
And I think the fear is giving everyone, they always your worst nightmare.
Never, ever answer me back again.
People shitting it, people there cracking up. I don't know what to expect. I'd rather not know anyway, to be honest.
If I'm going
to
be up there amongst the best of them, if I could be, it's going to get worse, surely.